Hello and welcome back to Enduro. So last time we experienced, well, quite the mind prison. We were forced to question our own reality and what drives us, our fears, and we were confronted with our unfortunate past. And right now we should speak with Jasper, and I very much suspect that this is not right. This is still part of the dream. Hello, Jasper. Carson is busy? Holy shit. Can we talk to him?
Oh, hey. Oh. Good to see you awake. How are you feeling?
Where are the others? Dunbar, Callie, and Mr. Barter? Not Dunbar. He's an asshole. But Callie and Mr. Barter? They're okay in my book. let's just ask that.
Good question. The room was empty when I came here. Actually, that's quite weird, now that you mention it. The entire temple seemed kind of deserted. Probably a ceremony or something like that. Now, tell me, how are you holding up? I heard this trial's quite the feat. Apparently, some of the novices never wake up again.
Fine, I guess. Where are we?
In the temple. The Curarium, to be precise. You were brought here when you were traveling with that Eichsen guy. I think the others are already awake, but I didn't want to leave you here, so I thought I'd just stay. I mean, hey, you are a keeper of the first sigil now, aren't you? I believe congratulations are in order.
I'm not letting it get to my head. Oh, that's a... Sure, thanks is okay too.
Well, you shouldn't. Do you know why? Because you're pathetic. Simply pathetic.
Excuse me?
I said you are pathetic. At first, we believed it would be more exciting this time. But now that we've seen the new prophet, our hopes are gone. You're a joke.
A nobody who let his only friend kick the bucket.
As if you'd ever accept that. You humans are always so damn persistent, aren't you? Why? Why can't you just let go?
Because in the end, you are powerless, just as all those before you. And you, Prophet, you are the biggest joke of all.
You are nothing but an urchin.
A weakling.
And a murderer.
And that is why you will burn. All of you. The cleansing will happen, and there's nothing you can do to stop it.
So you are the ones behind it, aren't you? Why are you doing this? What have we done to you?
What have you done to us? You are so naive. The world is an interplay of cause and effect. And the only logical consequence of your existence is annihilation. That's the way it was, and that's the way it's going to be. But enough of the banter, urchin. We wanted to meet you, and so we did. Even though the result is rather sobering. Now wake up. Keep on stumbling through the mist.
I don't trust this either. Are we still in the dream? Can you wait by my bedside? I like you a lot. He's genuinely concerned. Hello.
Thank Malphus. I was starting to think I was the only one. How are you? You look exhausted.
Well, I kinda had a nightmare. But whether it was higher forces trying to scare me, or my mind playing tricks on me, it doesn't really matter. Shocks of shocks. Shock of shocks, I am. Might go for that. Alright, I suppose. Thanks for asking.
Then you have a remarkable constitution. Usually the after effects of the potion last for days. But it's good to see the Grandmaster was right after all. I woke up just a few hours earlier, and he was here in the meantime. He didn't doubt for a single second that you would make it. But I suppose mutual congratulations are in order. We made it. We passed the trial.
We did? The trial is basically doing drugs in the forest? Huh. Certain many people would just sign up for the trial. So does that make us keepers now?
Almost, yes. All that is left to do is to take the oath, and then Grandmaster Aranthiel will exalt us to the keepers of the first sigil. Speaking of whom, he also told me some things while you were asleep. About the Pyreans, about these dreams, and of course, about this cycle. This is so bizarre, really. At first we're told out of nowhere that the gods have died, and now humanity is on the brink of extinction. This is a lot to take in.
I wouldn't say the first thing, because I don't really know how things were before the Lightborn. As far as I know, the death of the Lightborn kind of caused this event. I don't know. From what I know, the Lightborn weren't so bad. Yeah. It's a tough cookie, Kalia. I kind of can imagine how you feel. Well, just like that. How long ago? What's your thoughts on that? I figured, what do you make of all this? The cycle, the cleansing?
Hard to say. I never had those dreams the Grandmaster talked about, even though I'm magically gifted. But then again, I always had the feeling that the Red Madness was more than an ordinary disease. Well, I suppose all of this explains a lot. At least now I can understand why the Grandmaster was willing to break all the traditions of the Order just to get you exalted to be a Keeper. According to him, most of our battle against the cycle will stand or fall with you.
Yeah, that is true, actually. I wish I could say that with the same conviction as him. To be honest, I don't really think I've understood all of what happened to me yet.
Yes, I believe that. It's a great responsibility you've been given. And as impressive as your skills are, I would not want to change places with you.
My skills are not that impressive. I'm an apprentice sword fighter. That's basically it. I can also get a better price from merchants. Well, not that impressive. So, what's our next step? Are you gonna be with me? As a follower? Because I would really love that. I feel so alone. Go everywhere alone. And, yeah. And I like you a lot. So, what's the next step?
Well, as I said, we both have to take the Holy Oath. You should talk to the Grandmaster as soon as you're ready. He's waiting for you in the Emporium.
We both? What about Dunvar?
Right. Dunvar. The apothecary examined him about an hour ago, and it doesn't look good. It's likely that he'll never wake up again.
Well, as much as I hate the guy, I'm not just gonna celebrate when he dies. He was a really, really dumb young man. Maybe. Well, Well, I kind of said that I would welcome his death. But I would have welcomed his death. I would have... If someone had to die, it should have been him. But I wouldn't just flat out kill him. I don't know. Anyhow, I'm not gonna be the guy who just shows up at the funeral and says, "Hell yeah!" So, he will die, he doesn't deserve that. He was an asshole, but he doesn't deserve that.
No, in spite of everything. You know, Dunwar was one of those people who tried to gild their insecurity with boastful behavior. The reality is that he was the last of his bloodline, and his faith in the path and his destiny as a keeper were all that he had left. And who knows? Maybe he would have been a great help to the Order with the right guidance. But I guess Master Bartar's revelation was just too much for him. It's hard to be told that everything you've lived for was a lie.
This game impresses me again, that Kalia Sakurash again showed wisdom and recognized that his Dunvar's asshole behavior was because of his character weakness. He was insecure, he was weak, he made himself better by saying by being an asshole, basically. I could go into it, but I really want to explore the next options. Well, he really prided his noble heritage, and he was just an asshole. And he was very eager to prove himself as well. When he healed the guy with the red madness. Yeah, he was a dumb young man. It was completely in character, but he was annoying nonetheless. No, I definitely don't want to talk later. Dunvar was the last of his bloodline?
Yes. All of the Dalmordans fell victim to the Great Flesh Maggot Plague of 8215. Actually, it was almost sad to see him running around and boasting about his nobility, though everyone knew that without the help of the Order, he would have probably ended up living in a shack in the Undercity. If you can call that living.
Interesting character option. I actually wouldn't make too much of it. She just seems like a... She's young and she's kind, but she also seems like a person who experienced a lot. He really knows people, and she really knows people, and yeah. I guess if you get used to the ups and downs of life, nothing really surprises you. Nothing really hits as hard anymore. But I definitely want to ask her about this. You don't seem to be too shaken up over all of this. The death of the Lightborn, I mean.
Well, maybe I just don't show it as much. But yes, in a way, you're probably right. I suppose that's mainly due to the fact that to me, as opposed to Dunwar, the Order always stood for an idea. And an idea doesn't die with the one who first thought of it. Funny that the Grandmaster said nearly the same thing during the Exaltation. Dunwar would have considered it blasphemy.
I really like that. I don't really want to argue about that. Again, she stands for the idea, not necessarily Lightborn. So, she's definitely not responsible what the Lightborn did. She just wants to do some good. So, I don't feel like saying that. Interesting thought. Speaking of Dunwar, what was the thing at the ritual place all about? He called you a witch.
I knew the question would come eventually. I suppose the answer depends on whether you're in the mood for some gloomy talk. Sooner or later, you'll hear it from someone else anyway, so why not from me first?
Well, actually, I want to hear from only you. Because I don't give a shit what other people say about you. I want to hear what you have to say. I know better than to trust rumors. I'm interested. I'm not gonna judge you for it, for sure. I wouldn't have asked if I weren't interested. I already knew you were a good person. Whatever happened, I'm just glad you shared it with me.
As you wish. Where should I start? Maybe with the fact that I don't remember anything that happened before my sixth winter. I don't know where I was born, and I never got to know my parents.
Well, it's not that surprising. You don't remember? How come?
I wish I knew.
What? That's it?
What I do know, though, is that the first memory I have is of waking up in the middle of some village. It was dark, and I felt dizzy, and I don't know, empty? That's probably the best way to describe it. I eventually found the strength to get up and look around, and, well, that's when I realized what was actually going on around me.
But it's not uncommon to, well, it's actually pretty common to remember very emotionally charged memories. That makes them more significant, easier to remember. What?
The entire village. It had been destroyed. There were corpses everywhere. Men, women, children. And the houses had been crushed as if some mad god had rampaged through the streets there. And it had all just happened hours before because the destruction was still fresh. Whatever it was, I didn't have much time to think about it. As soon as I got up, I saw three riders coming through the smoke. One of them got off his horse, ran towards one of the corpses, and started screaming something in my direction. Then I felt a blow on the back of my head, and I lost consciousness. By the name of the sun, it's strange to talk about it like this. It's been so long, but the memory feels as if it had happened yesterday.
Wow. I hate that. I hate that line. Oh. That's basically saying, oh, I don't really care. I thought it was a good story. Anyway, let's just go. Why did those men attack you?
Well, it turned out the riders were hunters who had come from that village. They must have observed the whatever it was from the distance and ridden back to the village. At least I think that's how it went. I guess I'll never find out. The reason they thought I was somehow involved is that the village priest found me a couple of days before it happened near a shrine in the wilderness. Apparently, I was wearing torn clothing, and no matter what the apothecary tried, he couldn't wake me up from my comatose sleep. And it seems that made the writers think I was some kind of witch child, or unholy beast, whichever you prefer.
They really thought a 6-year-old child destroyed an entire village? That's ridiculous. Not necessarily impossible, but you're probably just a victim. And if you are not, and if you did it because you were so magical, you still can be blamed. You're doing everything you can to get your magical talent under control.
For you, maybe. For them, as simple people, it was probably the best explanation they had. And think about it, it's not that far off. A motherless child who neither talks nor breathes steadily is found abandoned on the roadside and has a strange mark on her face. They leave to go hunting, and when they come back, they find their village in ruins, with that foundling child being the only survivor. You have to admit, it's not that much of a stretch, even if those men hadn't been superstitious farmers.
Well, I understand their behavior, but it's not uncommon to see something like that. It's sad, but not uncommon. I see. And these men wanted to do what exactly? Take revenge?
Probably. Truth be told, I try not to think about it too much. And actually, it doesn't matter, because I somehow managed to get away before they could do anything. I even made it to Ark all by myself, which didn't turn out to be much of an improvement in the end, because I was pathless.
They brought you into the Undercity, right?
Yes. Thinking about it now, I actually wonder how I made it through my time down there. But maybe that's one of the advantages of being a child. You don't think. You just act. Still, the winters down there were cruel, and if Master Tyrus hadn't found and taken care of me, I probably wouldn't have made it through my second year.
Master Tyrus, a keeper, adopted you?
Yes, otherwise I would not be here. Yeah. He saw me, and he knew what he had to do, is how he put it. Of course, the Order wasn't too happy about a pathless child in the Scuola, just as some aren't happy about you being here. But Tyrus was a highly regarded man, and that's why they let it slide.
I wouldn't necessarily question it. I don't particularly like either of these choices, so... I don't really want to question her story. Why is the Order so preoccupied about Pathless trying to get into their ranks? It's not like we both don't have our reasons.
That's right, we do. But we are both still Pathless, and that disqualifies us according to the Holy Verses. I guess now you understand why I was never as connected to Malphus's teaching as Dunwar was. To some of the Keepers, I am still an outcast. And no matter what I do, I always will be.
So he just saw you and decided to adopt you? That sounds too good to be true, to be honest.
It does, yes. But then, he had lost both his wife and daughter 5 years before he found me, so maybe I was some kind of substitute. I don't know. But in the end, it doesn't matter. I owe him everything. He was a good man, and that's all that matters.
Well, it's impossible for me to like you any more than this. You're also very wise. And kind. So Master Tyrus granted you the novitiate?
Yes. And now I'm here. Well, here we've reached the end of my impressive tale. I hope you liked it.
I'm glad you shared it with me. What happened to Master Tyrus? Where is he now?
Gone. He was very old, and there was nothing anyone could do about it. But I'd prefer not to talk about it, if you don't mind.
Sure. You're definitely not the fisherman's daughter from the village, I'll give you that.
No, I guess I'm not.
So that means Dunwar believes that this story about you being responsible for the destruction of that village is actually true?
He does, yes, and he's not alone in his opinion. One of those hunters recognized me in the market my first year as a novice, and you can imagine that it was easy pickings for those who were already against my presence in the Order. From then on, they added names to the derogatory stares. Demon child, witch, whatever they could come up with.
But I'm really glad, and you should be really proud, that despite all of that, you still succeeded, and you still managed to stay true to yourself. And that's no easy task. You really made your father proud. Well, you're talented, intelligent, and pretty. Many reasons for the other novices to envy you.
Yes, maybe. You know what's funny? To some extent, I'm glad to be who I am. That way, people just leave me alone, and that gives me more time to focus on what's important. On my goals.
I understand the feeling. It's maybe hard to... not to be the fisherman's daughter, but our unique hardships define who we are, and at the end of the day, even if it's tough as hell, I wouldn't really change anything. Well, I might change something, but not the entirety of who I am, and that's it. Which would be?
Several. But I'd say that's enough of the gloomy stories, don't you think? There will be plenty of time for chatter in the future. Maybe.
I really like you. Let's talk later. I should go see the Grandmaster now.
You should. It's already late, but if you want, I can show you the most important places in the temple before you go to the Emporium. What do you think?
That would be nice. Honestly, I just want to spend time with you. That was... I just played it off as like, eh, I got it, but... The dream kind of freaked me out. Not that I really question my skills anymore, but... the task ahead of us is something no one managed to do. And it would be tough. That would be nice. I could use some company right now.
Good. Then get your gear from the chest by your bed and we'll go.
Oh. My gear's here? That's a good sign. My chest! Oh, can I take it off?
Well then, let's go.
Oh, wait a sec. I believe it's time to dress up. Oh, favorites are still there. Or maybe not, all of them. And that looks okay. Maybe, oh, torch. That needs to be hotkeyed as well. And the bow. And I believe we are ready to go. Set up just as we were before the whole trial. And I'm still running around with a torch inside, like an idiot. But I didn't do. Oh, let's just not steal. Sorry, Dunbar. Can we do anything with you? Well, I guess we can give you mercy, but maybe too soon for that. I hope this is not just a part of the... Oh, really? Oh, boy. It very much looks like it. Healing Gartles. All bloody. Oh, can I? If I'm stealing in my mind? Is it still considered stealing? I hope I didn't lose you. Okay. Either something really brutal happened here. Or this is still a dream. Or maybe the healing otters are all supposed to be bloody? I very much doubt that. So... Oh. See someone. Maybe a good sign. Kalia.
That one.
Move along.
Oh.
Alright, this is the sanctum. It's a place of silence and prayer, and also where we'll be exalted later.
In life, as in death. Pathlessness, wherever you look. Where is this supposed to lead?
Let's hope he knows what he's doing.
Oh shit.
I have to remember that.
This is Holy Ground, Outlander. You do not belong here.
Are you kidding me? I'm a keeper just like you. Well, I guess technically not a keeper just yet. Oh, where's she?
Walk blessed.
The guard distracted me. Sorry.
Walk Let's go. Blessed.
I like looking around. Oh, so a lot of tables, alchemy and enchanting tables downstairs. We can use this. I don't really know. Well, we can make a note of this. So if you need to do some alchemy or enchanting, and this is a good place to go. Of course, it's Bloody Night. Oh. Do you have some other line? Oh no, she's just too stunned. Oh. I'm coming, I just like looking around.
Okay, I think you've seen this place before. We call this part of the temple the Chronicum, and in here is gathered the knowledge of the Order, written down in books and parchments.
You're talking
Plus,
about the gate.
All of the experiments and research on artifacts and magic is done here. So it's a place you'll probably see often in the near future. Ah, and just below the Chronicum is the Temple Smithy. You should go there if you need equipment. Over there, that's the Scuola and the Quarters. Keepers and the Novel. There's also a training room where everything from swordplay to marksmanship can be trained and taught. You will find some skilled teachers there. Well, I think that's about it. You've already been to the Emporium, and I assume to the Eye of the Gods as well. I suggest you speak to the Grandmaster as soon as you're ready to take the oath.
Fair enough. What will you do?
Prepare myself, probably. Now walk blessed. I will see you soon.
Thanks, and take care.
Yeah, I know what you mean. But don't worry.
You're saying Asmiri's over here? And some training rooms. Skula. Bunch of skulas. Okay, can we go downstairs? Yep, we can. Armory. So this is the smithy, I guess. Oh, we can break in. Can't even break into the warehouse. I'll just go into the armory. It's odd that it's open at this hour. Or maybe we can just take stuff from it. Well, we are part of the Order now. Maybe not yet. There. You're right. Hello? Are you sleeping? Don't worry, I'll just... Oh. Can I just jump in? I can't.
This is the swords. I have to remember that.
Swords? Chest. Okay, that looks pretty good. Oh, someone here? Watch of the Keeper. Not bad at all. I can take the soul gems. It's gonna come in handy. Oh, that's no good. Really heavy. So...
Hello. Sorry for picking your lock. You gonna get pissed at me?
I haven't seen your face before. What do you want?
Possibly steal some stuff from you? Possibly not. Let's go back to sleep, no need to worry. I actually came to trade? Am I good at stealing? Even from a sleeping person, I'm really bad at it. But that's pretty bad. If you can't even lift one coin from a sleeping person, well, you're not really a master thief. The problem is I don't really like the chance-based system, because what if I just mess it up? Oh, need expert. Holy crap. Did we get expert? I'm just too curious. I just go back and get expert. If I have the points. Hopefully I have the points. I need to pick expert up someday anyway. Might as well do it soon. Ultimate gives you a copy of a pick-lock's key? I don't like that. Full draft faster? That's actually pretty good. Nah, I don't really care about that. Well, that's actually not bad, but not as good as drawing your bow faster. Expert locks? Master locks. Okay. What else is there? Huh. That's not really an issue for us. Doesn't really matter. Let's just go rapid shot and expert locksmith. Not really sure why bows and locksmith is in the same tree. So we have one remaining. Okay, that's good, but not really sure what to use it on. Maybe we can go for suitable armor. Potions are more effective. That's actually quite good. Actually pretty good, as long as we use potions. So this could be a good pickup as well. Wow. So let's just go for the suitable armor. That's a pretty significant armor increase. And the second point in this is interesting as well. Alright. We're good. Let's just go out. Alright. Gonna pick your lock. Oh crap. We were close. Oh, really? Oh, that's more like it. That's really a... Those are some good drinks. Question is, do we wanna... Oh, let's take that. Do we wanna... take that as well? I don't want to seal that, but... What over your door? Let's close it.
Place is the swords. I have to remember that.
Alright. forgot what I was trying to say. It's okay. Oh, this is the smithy. That is what we were looking for. On temple. Okay. Good place. We're actually looking for a bed. Can we sleep in your bed? In the bed you guys have? Please? I know I have a bed. Oh, I can sleep in this bed? That's great. Thanks for that. So, can we trade now?
Ahoy.
Oh.
Ahoy.
Ahoy to you too.
Ahoy.
And how about you?
I haven't seen your face before.
Oh, what? I need some equipment.
Do you now?
Don't run away.
Well, if the keepers let you run around in here, I suppose you have business with the Order. So I guess there's no harm in trading with you. But don't think it'll cost you any less than somewhere else.
That is fine. I'm not looking for handouts. So what you got? You got some books? Apprentice? Oh, we don't really care about apprentice books. Apprentice, adapt book on one hand. You wanna pick up these 5 books? I guess I can do it. Archery. I'm more of a one-handed guy right now. Do I want to increase my light armor? Oh, actually we don't. We want to save some cash for for ambrosia potions.
Walk blessed.
Okay. Heading out. Thanks for the books. Then we can sell the stolen items here. I believe there is a perk that allows us to sell the stolen items anywhere. Not sure if you want to pick that up. We might do that, but it's in the sneak tree. Or at least the... I don't know, adventurer tree? The left side? It's with the sneak options. Anyhow, no need for a torch now. Just go this way. And do we wanna talk to the Grandmaster and well, we might as well do that if you're here. Huh. Oh, really? Yeah, I don't really want to go into the Emporium from here. I'd rather just go up the stairs I came down. And look for Brantiel in the Emporium. Ah, he's in the Emporium, of course. How are we doing with the skill points? We have some crafting points that we could use. Our arcane fever is 21%. So at least drinking one potion would be nice. Oh. Emporium. Alright. You're in the right place. Oh, okay. We're using torch. Where are you? He must be here somewhere. I guess he's upstairs. Take that. Magic Imbu rope. Where did they catch me stealing? Well, I'm not really stealing, I'm just appropriating supplies for myself that I need. Do I want to bother with that? thing is, we can only set it to... like, we can only set it to a fence. The bolt! Hmm. Oh, and we now have enough locksmith, or yeah, I believe it's called locksmith, to break into the bank like we wanted to. And I believe Milbert also gave us a...
I believe this could work. It sounds absurd.
Who are you?
The mercenary, he might not be a keeper. Shining knight of Castle Star Sound, but he's better than most of your men. I want him.
Walk.
And you will need to convince your true chesser of it.
He's somewhere. He's upstairs.
That's so.
Anyway, we have a safe deposit box in the bank. That's what I wanted to say. I just listened to them.
I hope so.
Prophet, good to see you. How do you feel?
Like someone who had a bad trip? Well, I'm actually a little bit cross with you that you never told me that the ritual could have killed me. Leave something out like that again, and it will be the last time I work for you. Yes. I know you think everything is at stake, but if you're not sharing information with me, then screw you.
Oh, what? So little confidence in yourself. I knew you would pass. If I had doubted your abilities, even to the slightest, I would have never spoken out for you. In any case, all that is left to do now is to recite the oath. Then we will finally deal with the more urgent matters.
Well, you guys don't exactly have the trial. How should I say it? Well. Well, simply put, Dunbar is basically dead. So, he was not prepared for the trial. So don't act so cocky, like, oh yeah, I know you would pass. Maybe me, but come on. Not everyone passes. What do I have to swear on? The dead gods? My loyalty towards the Order?
None of it. You'll see.
Oh. I'm good with that. Fine. I'm ready when you are.
The ceremony needs a little preparation. One day at least. Come back then. Even if it hurts to lose more time, the cleansing approaches, I can feel it. Just this night I had another of the dreams.
What did you see?
People I knew, including you. But these people weren't themselves. There was something else, and it spoke through them. They mocked us and said our struggle against the cycle was pointless. It was peculiar. I believe that these beings are connected to the cycle. They must be the ones who cause it.
Interesting, I had the same dream before I woke up in the curarium.
You did? That is interesting. It must be related to our roles as emissaries. Maybe there is a connection between us.
Any idea who or what these beings are?
None. Maybe they are demons or magical entities of some kind, but they are different from everything I know. In any case, if they are indeed responsible for the cycle, they are our enemies. That's what matters for now. Come back tomorrow for the ceremony.
What? I don't believe we need to talk right now. So, we need to come back tomorrow. And, till then. Hunt Wild Mage. Well, we have something to do. We have some quests. We have some assignments to do. And we'll be busy. Where is she? We need to find Ellie and Ark. Anyhow, I believe this is a good time to take a break. So hope you had fun and see you on the next one. And have a good one, guys.